Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. John and I are just finishing up a 3-day install on this house in New Brighton. It was built in 1966 and had an initial radon level of 6.6. So we did sub-slab depressurization, and we had a few challenges here, so let's go ahead and take a look and see how we ended up coming out on this one. So this is a walkout, and here's the living room area. So we had our diagnostic test holes. We had one right here, and then we had one in that corner because those are kind of our furthest spots. And then you'll notice this duct tape on the floor. And we do have baseboard heat. So we've got these copper lines that run below the slab, and they all come back to our boiler. So that was one thing we were concerned about when we did this job. So I'll show you how we came about locating all this stuff. If we go look at the boiler here. So here's their office. We've got a bathroom here, and then a bedroom up there, another bedroom here, and then kind of another area there. And they are going to remodel here in a few years, so they're just kind of getting everything ready. So back to our boiler lines that are below the plumbing. We had Nick from Radar Guys come out, and he located these lines for us using ground penetrating radar. And then he used his sewer camera to find the drain plumbing for us, because we want to be next to plumbing on sub-slab depressurization systems so that we can take advantage of that settling that has occurred. And he also used a transmitter to help locate these copper lines. So coming back to the boiler here, you notice we've got one line in the corner here, and then we've got two that go down there. So we had Nick locate those so we could see exactly where they were, because our radon mitigation system is right here. So our first suction point is here. We're about 3 inches from our boiler lines that go down those copper lines. And our piping runs up from our first suction point. It goes up and all the way through the chase, so you can't see that in the closet above. We were able to barely fit it in the chase, and we got to maintain an inch of clearance from that single wall, or sorry, that double wall B vent. So we go up through, and then our pipe runs to the back side of the attic so that you can't see it from the street, where we exhaust out through. The radon fan is in the house attic, so we maintain the aesthetics of the house. So we found with this first suction point, we weren't reaching everything because we had 5 diagnostic test holes. So we had to get next to our plumbing. So we had a few options. If we come this way, that main drain or the clean out is up here by the water meter, and the plumbing runs back over to here. So we had 2 options to get next to that plumbing from the suction point. We could either come across the ceiling and drop down, and they would soffit it in later and drop into this area, or we could stitch over to here, and the customer preferred to have stitching. So what we did, they're again going to remodel in a couple of years, so the carpet wasn't a big deal for them. So we pulled up this carpet and we stitched these 2 holes. So we cored a 5-inch hole through the slab, and then we dug a tunnel over to our main suction point on the other side here, and we dug over to where we get the settling for where this plumbing is. So we did some stitching there, and that allowed us to reach this front corner where we had one of our test holes. So we still were not reaching over here. So if we go back in this room, so what we did for our second suction point is tee off there, our main riser, and we go over to the left through the floor joists, and then through this closet on the other side of above the drywall, and then we drop down to get under the floor joist in that closet, and then we come across here into the cedar closet, and he's going to soffit this in later or when he remodels. And then we come down and we've got our second suction point here. And Nick from Radar Guys earned his money right here, because that boiler line ran right through here under the footing, or the radiator line. So he was able to scan that, and he found the footing. So from here, we stitch under that footing and we get out into the living room area. So I'll show you that. So that cedar closet is right on the other side of this wall. So our second suction point is there. We almost lost John. Our second suction point is on the other side. And then what we did was pull this carpet up, and then we've got five more of those stitching holes to get over to the walkout where we typically find some settling. And we're also next to the plumbing here, which is on right here. There's plumbing. There's a main drain that runs there. So we ended up cutting out the back of the cabinet because we had a pretty massive air leak here. So I'll let John come in here in a second, but this sheetrock ran down and then they poured the slab up to it. So the sheetrock was in first and they poured the slab. So we had a pretty sizable, you know, half inch gap open, and we were losing a ton of our airflow from our radon system. Was pulling a bunch of conditioned air from the house, and it wasn't allowing us to reach very far, especially in that front corner or that walkout corner. So the customer was okay with me cutting the back of this cabinet open, and then I cut the sheetrock out and then foamed that so that we could seal this up and reach further. So that allowed us to reach that front corner there. There's not really much to see upstairs just because we go through the chase and you can't see it. And then in the attic, it's hot out. I'm not going back in the attic. So I won't show you that. It's just a fan in the attic. We ended up using a Fantec RN4 EC, and we had it dialed into 7. That gave us a pressure field extension that we were looking for. We ended up with 83 watts, and figuring we had 60 CFM, figuring 25 of that is coming from the house, so conditioned air loss. Our operating costs were estimated at about $184 a year. And then one thing to mention here is there's a lot of stuff going on in here. They just had this boiler replaced, and I'm sure it's gonna need to be worked on or replaced again in the future. So we made this section of pipe removable. So there's a fern coat here and a fern coat here, so they can loosen these up and pull them out and then undo the clamps here, and this chunk of pipe will come out. So if they need to get access to anything to replumb it, they can do so. And we kind of gave them some instructions there. So in filming that video, I realized that I did not have thermal shielding here. So our pipe has to be an inch away from double wall B vent, which is what we have up here. But down here we had single wall. It's single wall from here down to the boiler and the water heater. So a single wall, we've got to be 6 inches from. So we added this piece of thermal shielding metal so that we're now able to put our pipe there. And I misspoke earlier. We didn't go through the floor joist because we don't cut through floor joists, do we, John?
No.
We went between the floor joist. And last but not least, and the best part, is since we plugged in that radon fan this morning, our radon levels were around 3 this morning, and it's been continually dropping. Radon fan's only been up and running for a few hours, but we're now running
3.8 this morning.
And now we're running 0.35. And it should continue to drop from there. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks for watching.